Hi, Pisces. This is your April reading in general for Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. So if you're watching for your Sun sign, could apply to all things, your Rising sign, specifically for career, your Moon sign, anything emotional, like your emotional self, maybe how other people are perceiving you, your love life, etc. So we're going to go all over all of those things and then give you a crystal of the month to help you out. So let's get started.
छाया आसमान देखो झूमता गगन हे छाया आसमान देखो झूमता गगन
Pisces, in general, what is April's lesson for you? Like, what are you struggling to get through or learn in April? And they're saying it's been very challenging for you to live in the present moment, okay? To kind of like express love into like every single thing that you're doing 100% of the time, being really focused and mindful. And that could be affecting you potentially, like not only in work because you could be distracted, it could affect you in relationships, like people feel like you're not paying full attention to them or disrespected because you're checking your Facebook and you're checking your email at the same time you're supposed to be having dinner with them or something like that. So let's just see kind of how this all plays out. Now, in regards to your work life, your money, your career, what can you expect in April? And they're saying it's kind of time for a rest. You either need to sleep more or sleep better. Perhaps you'd be overworking yourself. And they're like, for what? You're not making more money. Like, for example, if you're not working for yourself, right? Like if you work for a corporation or a business and it's not yours, what are you killing yourself for? Like, if you died because of stress tomorrow, they would hire somebody else within a week. See what I mean? So you got to think about that. That's what Spirit wants to tell you. They're like, because just do the best you can. Don't be stressing yourself out so much because there's not very much reward in April as a result of that. They're like, so you're making the decision to like kind of go all in on something, and why? It's damaging you, okay? Now, in regards to your love life, what's up? Coupled Pisces, keep doing what you're doing. Things look good. They're saying like you won't experience much challenge this month in your relationship, and really it can grow into beautiful, wonderful things, even bigger and more beautiful than you anticipated if you just keep doing what you're doing. So you're doing everything right. For those of you who are single, they're saying you might be attracting people who are dishonest. And so you've got to decide to shift that energy. It's like this month is all about your decisions, okay? So far is kind of what I'm seeing. Like, you've got to decide, like, this is good enough for me or this isn't good enough for me. This is fair to me, this isn't fair to me. Because all of this drama, like, you got to walk away from it, and it is your decision to do so. They say, like, really embrace all of this, like, fiery, passionate, enthusiastic sort of confidence about what you're doing in your love life, and just kind of have that knowing that the next thing is going to be good, because the people that you're attracting currently are not the kind of people that you want to move forward with. They say karma's a bitch and it'll backfire on them, but for you right now, focus on only positive things and positive people, and don't be sad if you're single. Like, it's not better to be with someone just to be with someone, even though they're a shithead. Okay, they're saying like you can't control how other people act or what they do to you, and this is a lesson that you're still learning, but once you've fully learned it by the end of April, you'll be in a position to attract somebody who is for your highest good. Now, how are other people affecting your April? And they're saying they're giving you good ideas, inspiration, like this sort of enthusiasm. So this is a really good time for you to go out and meet new people. This is a good time to go out on an adventure. This is a good time to live it up with friends or to make new friends. They're saying this is a month, we've already talked about it in your money and career sector, where you don't need to be working as hard as you usually do. This should be a fun month for you. And as a result, you'll make deep bonds and connections. For those of you who are single, you could meet a soulmate this month, more towards the end of the month. But regardless, this is something that could happen for you, or the connections that you have to friends, siblings, relatives will grow stronger and deeper. And it's all really wonderful, good love vibes there. What about your emotional self? What can we expect? And they're saying, again, not always making the best decisions, especially in regards to work. So your work decisions, your career decisions are affecting your emotional body. And you feel like you don't have a choice, but you do have the choice. You have total power here. It is your decision. It doesn't feel like it, but it is. Okay, so your crystal of the month for Pisces is the Labradorite. So isn't that cute? I want to show you a few other ones because you know what? I've got them here on my desk anyway. It's hard to see with the light because they're polished, but some of them have some really pretty shiny stuff in there. I like this one because it has like kind of stripes almost on the back. I don't know if you can. Anyway, point is, what does the Labradorite help you with? It helps you to, number one, to discover your destiny. It gives you clarity and insight. So it'll help you kind of like work through that issue with like making decisions and what do I do next. It protects you against negative energies of other people. It gets rid of illusions that you have. For example, the illusion that you need to like kill yourself at work, because you don't. You don't. Because with that, you know, with that fire sign card, what was it? The King of Wands coupled with the Empress card, it's like your job is secure. People are still gonna look at you favorably if you just do a little less. It expands your consciousness. It prevents you from like this energy of loss. Okay, so it'll help you to keep that job even though you're not killing yourself working a zillion hours a week. It activates all of the chakras between here and here. So like your solar plexus up to your crown. It stimulates your imagination. It provides support in times of change. It gives you strength and perseverance. It manifests new ideas and childlike enthusiasm. So like with that exciting card, the Page of Wands saying, go out there and have a good time. Go on an adventure. This will like kind of put you on the path for like a really exciting adventure that Spirit's sort of trying to align for you. Does a ton of other shit. It'll get rid of period cramps if you got those. Relieves tension. Anyway. That's the Labradorite. So you can get your own somewhere, but if you get one from me, there's a link in the description box below that'll show you where to find them. And they come with all these videos on different ways that you could use them that are typically videos reserved just for the Crystal Club on Patreon. So love and light and have the best April ever. Thanks so much for watching this video and getting all the way to the end of it. I really appreciate your support. If you are interested in other videos, click here. If you are interested in subscribing, go ahead and click here. Hit that notification bell so that you get alerted to when new videos come out and also when I do surprise live streams. And then if you're interested in winning a free 20-minute video reading personally every month, go ahead and click right here. Mwah!